Fat.
Cat.
Sat.
Hat.
Fat.
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 Cat.
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 Sat.
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 Hat.
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 A fat cat sat on a hat, saw a rat on the mat, got a bat, had a chat with a gnat that he'd pat in a vat that was flat. Oh, yeah! Oh, yeah. Sorry about that. Small.
Ball.
Tall.
Wall.
Small.
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 Ball.
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 Tall.
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 Wall.
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 See the small ball on a tall wall. See it fall in a hall. See it crawl, give it all and call. Hi, y'all. See it's tall, wear a shawl. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Red.
Head.
Bed.
Red.
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 Head.
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 Fed.
Bed.
Bed.
Bread.
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 See the redhead being fed bread on his sled, made of lead as he sped to be wet, but he fled instead out ahead up to Ted in his bed, and he said, red head fed bread, small ball, tall wall, fat cat sat hat, and that's that. Scat!
Hey, you want to see some home movies I took? Huh? Okay. Hey, Ernie, roll them. Yeah, now. Good. Okay. Now, oh, these are going to be really exciting, okay? I used Ernie's camera on these. See? It's a pigeon. Oh, I love pigeons more than anything else in this world, besides oatmeal. Oh, now watch how these pigeons move. I took these pictures in Asbury Park. Look at the neck. Look at them move. Look at those feet. Oh, and see, I feel these pigeons are really unusually intelligent birds. I threw those breadcrumbs down and they knew just where to look for them. Now, watch this. This is exciting. Oh, see that? Huh? Oh, wow. Now, there's some more. They'll fly in a second. There they are. Oh, now, look at the balance on these pigeons. Look at the balance. Well, kind of fail. Now, see the one with the feathers? Right behind. Oh, you didn't see him. That was Bernie. He's really a character. I tell you. Boy, just looking at these pigeons makes me feel terrific. Every time I feel alone and slightly blue, that's when I begin to think it's what I'd like to start to do. And though it may not be the kind of thing that's quite your cup of tea, I recommend you pay attention to the little dance you gotta see. I love pigeons, and I love how they walk. And I've created a really cool dance called Doing the Pigeon. Doing the Pigeon. Dancing a little smidgen of the kind of ballet sweeps me away. Doing the pigeon. Doing the pigeon. People may smile, but I don't mind. They'll never understand the kind of fun I find. Doing the pigeon. I love it. Doing the pigeon. It's me. Doing the pigeon every day. Oh, boy, is that exciting? Now, I'll show you how to really do the dance good, okay? Oh, this is gonna be way out. Okay, feet, do your stuff. Careful. Dig this. all may smile, but I don't mind. They'll never understand the kind of fun I find. Doing the pigeon, doing the pigeon, doing the pigeon every day.
Hey, Bert, come here.
What?
I got something to show you. Come here. Now stand right here, Bert.
Stand
right here and look out to the front. Look out to
what's
the front.
What's that there?
Okay. Now stand right still and don't move. Okay?
Don't move?
No. Look out there.
Okay.
And don't move. All right. Now then, watch this. Here is one of Bert's eyes. See?
What's happening?
You're getting an eye drawn on you.
Oh.
And here is the other of Bert's eyes. And the eyes are what you use to see with. Right, Bert?
I guess.
Don't say anything, Bert. Now then, here is Bert's eyebrows going across the top. And the eyebrows, you see them up there?
Right, I can't even move.
Don't move, Bert. Now then, here is Bert's nose.
Ernie, what's going on?
No. Don't move.
I feel a fool.
And the nose is what you use to smell with, right? The nose. Now then, here is one of Bert's ears. On this side over here.
And it tickles.
Don't move. And here's the other of Bert's ears over here. Yeah. And up on top there is Bert's hair.
Please hurry.
Look at that. See the hair? All right. Now then, the side of Bert's head goes down here. See, this is the side of Bert's head. Don't move, Bert. You can't move. This is Bert's head going down here.
It's no fun, Ernie. Come on now.
No. It goes around there, and it goes up here. This is Bert's head. You going up there at the top? That's the shape of Bert's head. We all know the shape of Bert's head, don't we?
Come on, Ernie.
Now, here is Bert's mouth. Here's Bert's mouth. Don't move your mouth, Bert.
I can't move my mouth now.
Okay, there's Bert's mouth there. And just to finish it off, here's Bert's shirt. Let's do Bert's shirt.
Mm-hmm.
Here's Bert's shirt. Okay? You ready, Bert? Okay? Now, you can move, Bert. And now we have a picture of Bert. Look at that. Isn't that neat, Bert?
How'd you do that?
And you'll arrive at a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now if we slightly change us, that is rearrange us. In circle or line, we're still 5.
Thank you. Over?
Yes, Bigfoot, I am ready.
Okay. Ladies and gentlemen.
And monsters.
And monsters,
yes.
Thank you. And kids. Presenting Big Bird and Grover, who are here to explain to you the number two.
Yep.
Little Grover here will demonstrate by chinning himself two times, okay.
Should I start?
Okay, go ahead, Grover.
Okay, here we go.
That's one. Two. There, that was two chins. There.
Yeah.
That was fine.
Okay.
Yeah, that was fine, except
good.
I think you should do it again.
Again?
Yeah, make sure everybody understands, too.
Okay, this is difficult, you know, Big Bird.
Yeah, well, you're
okay,
doing
it. Okay, I do it for you. Here we go.
You're doing real
one
well.
One more time. Here we go.
Okay. Here we go. There's one. Another one, Grover. One, and another one makes two. There we are, two.
Okay, I can get down now, okay, Big Bird?
Well, I think it really wouldn't hurt if you did it again.
Oh, Big Bird, it would hurt very much.
Well, just try it again. Let's make sure we get the number two.
This is hard.
Really done well.
Okay, I think I can do it maybe just one more time.
Okay. Look at those muscles flex. There's one!
I'm not strong, but I'm wiry.
Yeah. It's not there. And there you have it, folks! Two! Wonderful, Grover! Wonderful!
Okay, I can get down now. Okay?
Well, yes, we've got the number two clear in everybody's mind.
Good, okay.
Now, folks, we present Grover doing the number 18. Go ahead, Grover. Grover?
Oh, I am all right, Big Bird. Yeah, I just want to rest a little bit.
Willy Wimple went a-boating, making dirty water here, pouring stuff there till the gunk was everywhere. Now if every kid did it, can't you see what an icky mess it would be? No place for fish to swim, no lakes for sailing in, no rivers, no streams, no submarines, no swimming ever again. Now with every kid in it, messy. No fun world it would be. Yuck.
Some clowns? More clowns! And more clowns!
No clowns.
We take you now to Kermit the Frog in another fast-breaking news story.
Yeah, I'll take a ham on rye. We'll make it a grilled cheese. Kermit the Frog here on Sesame Street News, and today we are going to interview the occupants of this cottage right here. And this is the cottage of the Three Little Pigs.
Three Little Pigs! I will count them as you talk to them.
I don't think that'll work, Count, actually.
Nonsense! Counting always works.
Okay, just try to stay out of the way, would you, huh?
One knock.
One knock, right. Gotcha.
Two knocks.
Now, will you cut that out?
Yes?
Oh, Kermit the Frog of Sesame Street.
One little pig!
Who's that?
Don't pay any attention to
him. Who is it, Harold?
Two little pigs!
Will you cut that out?
I'll tell you, this frog knocks on the door first, and then all of a sudden this guy starts counting. I don't know what's going on.
It's Kermit the Frog of Sesame Street News here.
All right.
Three,
now, what's going on?
Three little pigs!
What's going on?
What was that?
Shut the door. I think it's going to rain.
Wait a second.
No more of those weirdos.
Thanks a lot, Count, huh? Yeah. Maybe we'll just, we'll try the cottage next door. Maybe we'll have better luck over there. That's okay. It's all for you, Count, okay? Thanks a lot, huh?
No. Hmm? Don't worry about the Count. I will be as silent as a mouse.
Good.
Unless I find something else to count. Ah! One pussy willow!
Yeesh, oh boy.
Ah, one knock.
Listen, we're trying to do a television program here.
Huh? Ah, one camera. Hi, Mom.
Kermit the Frog of Sesame Street News here, sir.
One little person.
Little person? Oh, no. Do you mean this is the house of the...
The Seven Dwarfs, yeah?
Oh, no.
Seven Dwarfs, wonderful! I will count them all! Two little dwarfs!
Oh, boy.
Three! Four!
Shambles, this whole thing is turning out to be. Trying to do a television program, and he's...
Come back here! Six little dwarfs!
I think I'll just go ahead and...
Seven!
Oh, hello there. This is Grover up in a high tree. But that was hard climb. Today I'm going to show you about cute little adorable, lovable little birds. Yeah, and right in front of me is a bird's nest. And in the nest are three eggs. Yeah, and very soon, very, very soon, I think the little eggs are going to hatch. Yeah, let's watch carefully, okay? I think I hear one. Oh, there's one. Oh, there's two. Oh, there's three. Oh, dear. No, I'm not your mommy. I just up here for just to tell everybody about your bird. I'm not your... here comes the mommy bird. Okay.
Oh, my babies have hatched. I'll count them. One, two, three, four. Oh, and you're the cutest little bird of all. I have juicy worm for you.
No, I'm not a little bird. I'm a monster. I don't live here. I don't want a worm. No, I do not like worms.
Well, I'll leave it there for when you're hungry.
I will never get hungry for a worm.
Now it's time for our flying lesson.
Oh, wait, I do not fly. No, I am not your mommy. Your mommy is right here. I'm not your mommy.
Flap your wings.
I'm not your little birdie. I cannot fly.
Come on, Flappy. Flap,
I am not your mommy.
Flap your wings.
Remember what I said about birdies being cute and adorable and lovable? Forget it.
H. H.
Oh, for crying out loud. I was watching my favorite program and now this H comes on the screen. H. Let's see if I can fix it. Maybe if I change channels that might help.
H. H.
Oh, no good. For crying out loud. How am I going to fix this stupid set?
What are you watching?
Well, I was watching my favorite program, The Wonderful World of Pigeons, and all of a sudden, this H comes on the screen.
Oh, well, did you try changing channels?
Oh, yeah, I tried changing channels. It was coming to the best part, you know, and all of a sudden, it's H.
Hey, well, let me fix it for you.
It makes me so mad.
I'll fix it. I'll turn the set off here. Go back there and unplug the set, would you, Bert?
Well, you're really going to
unplug the set because I want to fix it.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. There. Let me just look in here. Here's your problem, Bert. Here's a problem. You had a hat in there, Bert. See, this is a hat, Bert. See,
how'd you do that?
See, a hat? Now, a hat is an H word, Bert, and so that's where the H was coming from the hat.
How'd you, you can't.
Oh, look at here, Bert. You had a hammer in there, Bert. Hammer is another good H word. See the hammer, Bert? That's the whole problem.
You can't reach in a television set like that. How?
Bert? Look what you had there. So you got a horn in there, Bert. Horn. Horn is an H word. Horn is another good H word, Bert.
I don't understand this.
See what else is in here.
Ernie, you're doing, you can't do it.
Here. Looky here, Bert. There's a house. You had a house in there, Bert. See the house? Now, house is a good H word, Bert.
I don't get it.
That was your problem.
I don't get it. Ernie, that's impossible. What you're doing in that TV with the house and the...
Look what you had here. Here's a hamburger, Bert. Hamburger's one of my favorite H words, Bert.
Why not? Sure, hamburger.
Oh.
Why not a hot dog? Sure.
Yeah, great hamburger,
anything.
Bert.
Sure.
Mm. Hey, Bert.
What?
You're still wearing a hat. Come here.
Well, I...
Take off a hat, Bert. Hat looks better on me anyhow. Okay, let's see. Oh!
This isn't happening.
Bert, look what I got in here, Bert. Oh, looky here, Bert. There's a hamster, Bert. You got a hamster in there, Bert. See the hamster? That's Henry the hamster. And hamster's a good H word, Bert. There's your whole problem. Now that's all fixed. You want to plug it back in and I'll turn it on, okay?
I'll plug it in, but I don't believe this.
Mm-hmm.
I've never seen anything like
this. Oh, no, it'll work now.
Okay, it's plugged
in. I'll just turn it on.
It's not happening. Look at that.
Bert, I'm sorry. I thought I had it fixed. Instead of repeating H's, now it's repeating I. Oh, Bert, let me fix it.
Wait, hold it.
I
like it.
You like it?
I love it. It's exciting.
It's exciting, Bert?
Yeah.
Henry,
before
I leave.
Wow, exciting isn't the word. It's new, it's thrilling, it's unique, it's new television talent, what we needed all along.
We take you now to Kermit the Frog for another fast-breaking news story.
Oh yeah, we'll make mine with anchovies and pepperoni.
Hi-ho, Kermit the Frog here of Sesame Street News, and I'm speaking to you today from Spain, where Christopher Columbus is about to set sail to discover America. And I think I see Christopher Columbus coming here now.
Roll your boat.
Pardon me, sir. Excuse me, Christopher. Kermit the Frog here of Sesame Street News.
Oh.
And I was wondering if I could ask you a couple questions. Just wondering, how is it that you intend to do that which you are planning to do here today? How are you going to discover America?
I'm going to sail across the ocean in them there three boats. See?
Uh-huh, you got three boats.
Yeah, here's one.
One.
That's two.
Two.
Then there's another boat over here. That's three.
Yeah, three boats.
Yep.
Oh, that certainly sounds like a good plan, sir. I wish you well on it.
Well, thanks a lot. But say, what time is it?
Oh, it's about 1492.
Oh, listen, if I'm going to discover America, I got to get going.
Okay.
Hello there, sir, mateys. Hoist the main sail, belay to jibber jabber, and jettison the supercargo.
Bye-bye.
Oh, there it goes. Look at that. There goes the first boat. Wow.
Hope he didn't forget the pizza.
Okay, well, listen, Christopher, you had three boats, and you take away one boat, and that leaves two boats, right?
Right.
Because three take away one leaves two.
That's right. We got to get the other one out right now.
Uh-huh.
Make mine the mitten mast, swab down the poop deck, starboard aft, port bow.
Bye-bye, everybody.
Bye-bye. Be good now.
Bye-bye.
Well, there goes another boat there. Wow. Now, you had two boats, and you take away one boat, and that leaves one boat. Because two take away one leaves one.
Right, you are.
Right.
Listen, I got to go before the other boat leaves.
Okay. This is a very exciting moment, folks, and remember you saw it first on Sesame Street.
All shores going ashore. Engines full ahead. Red sails in the sunset.
Christopher, Mr. Columbus, hey, the boat is still tied to the dock.
What?
I say the boat is still tied to the dock. Oops. Oh, this is Kermit the Frog on his way to discovering America.
Bye, Froggy. Bye, Frog. Have a good trip, Froggy.
Bye, Frog.
Bye, Frog.
Bye.
Isn't that exciting? Yeah.
Let's go see what other ships are sailing.
Right
okay.
The Sesame Street Little Theater takes pride in presenting A Flower Grows. Oh, welcome, dear viewer, to our little play. We're ever so glad that you joined us today. And now it is time for our drama to start. Whoops, for here comes a young man who calls himself Bart.
No, actually, I'm Ernie, you know. I'm not Bart at all. But in this play, I'm pretending to be Bart,
Ernie,
just because that
doing?
Was the way it was written.
Shh.
When.
Just do your lines.
Oh, yes. Oh, look, dear viewers, at what I have got. It's right over here, a great big flower pot. See? With hard work and labor and good honest toil, I have filled this pot up with some lovely rich soil. To grow a nice flower, here's what just you need. What you just need is what.
Go ahead, Ernie.
Okay, a pot and some soil and a small flower seed. How's that?
Ernie, you forgot to plant the flower seed.
Oh yes. Okay, here. Here we go. Thank you.
The seed's in the ground, but our story's not done. For to grow a nice flower, you also need sun.
I am the sun, and I shine in the sky. I'm warm like a fire, and round like a pie. I shine on the little seed planted right here. The warmth will soon cause a nice plant to show up. Appear.
Very nice, Harry.
Oh, thanks. Oh! Sorry.
The seed has some soil and some warmth from the sun, but still its dear life has just barely begun. For a flower needs water, like you and like I. And look what I see, it's a cloud in the sky. And look what I see, it's a cloud in the sky.
Come on, Cookie,
no,
that's your cue,
no,
come on.
Where
get
is
there.
He?
Get out there.
Be scared.
Cookie, say your lines.
I am the rain cloud.
I bring the nice rain to water the plants on the mountains and plain. Oh, gently, so gently, the spring showers flow and tenderly nourish the flowers below. Ernie, me do it! Oh, me do it! Oh, you did it
really well, too. Soil, sun, and water is all that we need. So now see the flower that grows from the seed.
Oh, look at that. Oh, gee.
I am the flower, and I want you to know how thankful I am that you helped me to grow. I once was a seed planted deep in a pot, but with sunshine and rain, I grew up a lot. I sprouted these petals so fragrant and gay to gladden your hearts. And thus ends our play.
Oh, neat, Bert. You really did a good job. What a lovely costume that is.
I feel like a fool.
Hey, did you make, what did you make those leaves out of?
Oh, they're lettuce leaves or something.
Lettuce! Oh, boy, a hairy lettuce leaves! Oh, delicious triumph!
I'm so hey, doing on, you guys. Come on.
Those petals are nice, too. Oh, delicious.
So, my dear viewer, our playlet is through. I hope you had fun and you learned something.
We all will survive. Now, we
dum 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 dum. Food. Seen this before. Huh. Four. what's going on here? 5? It keeps changing. 6. Oh. 7. Me glad me no ate it. 8. Wow. 9. 10. 11. It never stopped. 11. What next? Maybe 12? 12. Ho ho. 13. 14. What next? I knew it. 15. Maybe 16 next. 16. Yeah. 17. 18. Maybe up to 20, huh? 19. Maybe. 20. Oh, boy. That really is something. Maybe, instead of numbers this time, maybe come up with the cookie. Huh? Let's see.
Oh.
Frog.
Very nicely got it there, Cookie Monster.
You know what? That's scary.
Oh, you crumpled me up.
Oh, oh, oh.
Ugh. Never crumple a frog, Cookie.
Sorry about that.
Sorry.
Huh. Oh. Oh, wow. No, no. That's weird. Cookie.
In the room, and then I, the count, will count all the bats. You first, my pets.
Wait a minute, what do you mean, count all the counts? There's only one of you here.
Precisely so. One wonderful count. Okay, now it is my turn to count. One, two, three. Four.
I'm not hanging around here.
Five.
I'm hanging from the ceiling.
Six. Seven. Seven batty bats. Oh, wonderful. Fool them again.
Tiling for Prizes movie. And here's the ever popular star of daytime television, Guy Smiley.
Thank you, thank you, thank you. This is Guy Smiley, your host of the Dialing for Prizes movie. Now, we're going to be interrupting today's movie from time to time to call some lucky person in our viewing audience. And if they can tell me what the lucky word beginning with the letter F is, they will win some fantastic prizes. And now, here's today's lucky F word.
Today's lucky F word is fur.
fur. Yes, that's the F word for today, and the word is fur. And remember that F word and stay tuned because we might be calling you. And so now let's start today's exciting movie. You're going to love this movie. Start it. Isn't that a wonderful movie, ladies and gentlemen? That is a classic. And now we're going to make today's telephone call. Remember, if the person I call can tell me the lucky F word for today, he or she will win some fantastic prizes. So in a moment, we're going to find out who this lucky person is.
Hello?
Hello, to whom am I talking?
This is Mr. Lucky speaking.
Mr. Lucky, what a fortuitous name. Mr. Lucky, this is Guy Smiley.
Guy Smiley? On Dialing for Prizes movie?
Yes, that's right. Are you watching the show?
I am watching the show. I am. And I know the lucky word for today.
You do? That's great. What is it?
The lucky F word for today is fur.
Wonderful. You're absolutely right, Mr. Lucky.
I win. You mean I win?
Yes, you
do. I win. Oh, what did I get? What did I win, Mr. Smiley?
Well, just calm down and I will tell you. In honor of our F word for today, we're sending you some things that are covered with fur.
Things covered with fur? You mean like fur? Fur coats and
no,
stuff?
No, like monsters. Wonderful furry monsters.
Oh, no. What are you doing? No, get out. No, you can't come in here. No, out. Oh, don't do
Isn't
that.
Isn't that wonderful? And now we're going to return you to the exciting conclusion of our
Hold on. Just a minute. I'm Mr. Lucky, and I've come back to return your monsters.
You can't give them back. They're yours, Mr. Lucky.
Mine?
Yes,
no,
they
no.
are.
Oh,
aren't they wonderful? Look at those wonderful furry monsters. Isn't that wonderful? And this is Guy Smiley. And it's another lucky winner for today's Dialing for Prizes movie. Yeah, wonderful.
On a cold forest oak sat the crow, with a fine piece of cheese in his beak. Full of joy was the crow, with his meal above the snow, as the cold winds blew softly about him. As the cold winds blew softly about him. Like a flame came the fox through the forest, spied the crow with a smile and a bow. Said, "Hello, handsome crow, you are beautiful, you know. It's a shame you can't sing to your beauty. It's a shame you can't sing to your beauty." Thought the crow, "Handsome bird that I am, I can sing even more handsomely." From his wide open throat came an ice crackling note.
Bagar!
And the fox jumped and ran with the cheese. And the fox jumped and ran with the cheese.
Would you like to hear a story? This story is called The Monster's Three Wishes. Okay? Now, once upon a time, in a faraway kingdom, there lived a blue furry monster. And one day, as he was brushing his teeth, a very strange thing happened.
Based onto the brush and have a real good time. Da-dum dum.
Whoa, ha, ha! How do you do there, fella? How do you? Thanks a lot. Fantastic. Good to see you.
What? Who are you?
Me? Oh, I'm the genie of the toothpaste. See, I've been stuck inside this tube of toothpaste here for 3.5 weeks. You squeezed the tube and you set me free, you see.
What?
I'm so glad to be out of that there tube of toothpaste that I'll tell you what I'm going to do.
What?
I'm
going
to give you three wishes. Any three wishes you want, you tell them to me. I'm going to make them come true for you.
You, little man, give monster three wishes?
That's about it.
Oh, boy. Oh, let's see. What me wish for?
Think hard.
Oh, me thinking hard. It's not easy.
No.
Wait, stay there, little man, okay? Yeah. Bye-bye. Be right back.
Where are you going?
Bob?
Oh, hi.
Hi, hi. You know what?
What?
Me just get 3 wishes.
No kidding.
Yeah, but me not know what me going to wish for.
Well, let's see. Maybe I can help. Hey, I know you like cookies a lot.
Oh, it's tough. Hey, Bob, wait.
What?
Me like cookies a lot?
Yeah.
You know what?
No.
Me going to wish for 1,000,000 cookies.
Hey, that's terrific. Yeah. Good idea.
Wait, but me need place to keep all cookies in. I know what me wish for, but you keep reading.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
See you later. So, the monster rushed back to the genie and made his first wish.
Little man?
Yes?
Me wish for truck.
You want a truck, huh?
Truck.
Oh, you want my truck trick.
Yeah.
Oh, well, that's easy. Here we go. Shish-ba-bob, shazam! How's that? How do you like that? There's a truck for you, Phil. I haven't lost my touch, huh?
Oh,
how do you like it?
Well, little genie man, it nice. Oh, it nice. It a nice truck, but
Right.
Be right back, okay?
Hmm?
Oh boy. Oh, Bob.
Oh, hi.
Bob?
How'd it go?
Well, look what me get.
Oh, you got a nice little truck.
Me wish
there.
For a truck, but it not big enough to hold 1,000,000 cookies.
No, it certainly isn't. No.
Me got to wish for a bigger truck to hold 1,000,000 cookies.
You certainly would have to.
Keep reading, okay?
Okay, right.
Bye-bye.
See you later. Good luck. So, back he went again for another wish from the genie.
Well, genie?
Yeah?
Little genie man?
Mm-hmm?
Me now wish for... bigger truck.
Oh, you want a bigger truck?
Bigger truck.
Oh, wow. Okay, a bigger truck it is.
Oh, boy.
Okay, here we go. Shish kebab, shazam. Ah, there you go. How do you like that? Is that a truck? Is that a nifty truck, huh?
It okay. I mean, it
what do you mean it's okay? That's a spiffy truck. That's a neat truck. That's a neat truck trick.
Yeah, it's okay, but be right back, okay? Oh, wow. Hey, Bob.
Oh, hey.
Look what me get after.
Oh, you got another truck.
Yeah, the wish.
It's bigger than this one.
But, Bob?
Yeah?
But this bigger truck's still not big enough to hold 1,000,000 cookies.
No, I agree with you. It certainly isn't.
Oh, boy.
What are you gonna
do? Wait. Me going to wish for biggest truck of all.
For biggest truck?
Yeah.
That's a great idea.
But, wait. What you reading anyway?
Oh, it's a story about a monster.
Oh, me now got time. Bye-bye. Me busy.
See ya. Hey, but wait a minute. That's... Well, so anyway, he went back to make another wish.
Okay. Now,
yes?
Genie, Mr. Genie Man, me wish for biggest truck of all.
Oh, a great big truck, huh?
Yeah.
Okay, but remember, you asked for it. Here we go. Shish kebab, shazam! Wow, take a look at that, huh? Did I deliver? What do you say?
Oh, look at that!
Right.
That perfect!
Sure.
Oh, truck easily hold 1,000,000 cookies.
Oh, I'll hold whatever.
Okay, Genie, do your stuff. Now me ready for biggest wish of all. Me wish for 1,000,000 cookies. 1,000,000 cookies! Do it! Do your thing, me stand back, give you room. Give me 1,000,000 cookies, go, Genie!
Yeah, but no, I see you don't understand.
What?
We got a problem. See, I let you have 3 wishes, you know, and so you had your 3 wishes. Your first wish, you wished for a truck, and that's what you got. Your second wish, you wanted a bigger truck, and your third wish, you wanted a great big truck, and that's what you got. So that's all you got, you know.
Boy,
That's the size of it.
Me good at eating, but not so good at counting.
Well, I'm awfully sorry, but, you know, only 3 to a customer. That's it, fella, you know.
Oh, boy. Wait.
What?
If me hungry and there no cookies, only one thing to do.
What's that?
Eat truck! Rah! Rah!
What are you doing?
Oh, goodness.
Good heavens. My goodness, mercy me. I've never seen anything like this before. This is really
a friend of yours? Wow, look at that.
And so the genie went on his way, and the monster ate the truck, and I guess that's the end of the story.
Oh, Bob. Yeah. Oh, one bite of steering wheel?
No, thanks. I just ate.
Oh, you crazy. Delicious.
Okay.
I'm last.
I'm Crazy Melvin. Ha-cha!
Ladies and gentlemen, presenting the magnificent Splash-O. Take it away, Splash-O. Now kindly watch as the magnificent Splash-O climbs to the very top of this ladder and leaps from the platform into the tank below. Take it away, Splash-O. Whoops! Splash-O is at the bottom of the ladder. Try again, magnificent Splash-O. Attaboy, Splash-O, you're almost at the top. There he is. He made it. He's at the top of the ladder. Splash-O, you jumped from the top to the very bottom.